Hello friends, here in this video I'll be explaining the gas turbine power plant along with regeneration. That is, regeneration is one of the methods to improve the efficiency of a gas turbine power plant. So I'll write down here that it is gas turbine with regeneration. Now we know that after the turbine exhaust, the gases are at a very high temperature, and when the gases are at that high temperature, we are directly exhausting that gases into the atmosphere. In case of open cycle gas turbine, it means we are not utilizing the heat of the exhaust gases. So regeneration method is one of the method to improve the efficiency of the gas turbine power plant by utilizing the heat of the exhaust gas to heat the incoming air from the compressor. So in order to explain it further, I'll draw it with the help of a diagram so that we can understand it clearly. So this is the combustion chamber in which the fuel is injected or sprayed. Then I'll quickly go on explaining the parts. Here we have a compressor which is directly coupled to the turbine. In case of compressor, here we have atmospheric air as inlet, so this I'll call it as state 1. Then into the compressor, the air gets compressed, pressure and temperature increases, so we get state 2 out of the compressor. Now here we have a device, this is called as a heat exchanger. So the compressed air enters the heat exchanger at point number 2, then it leaves the heat exchanger at point number 3. After that, it goes into a combustion chamber as shown over here. So I'll denote it as CC, that is the combustion chamber. So in the combustion chamber, the fuel is sprayed, and so the temperature increases further of the mixture, that is of air and fuel, because here we have air in at point number 1. Similarly, at point 2 also we have air. At point 3 it is air, but the moment it mixes with fuel, and here we have direct mixing type, so at point number 4 we are going to get gas after the combustion chamber. Now that gas enters the turbine at high temperature. Then when it enters the turbine, there is expansion of the gases. It means the gases have high heat content, or we can say high amount of enthalpy. That enthalpy gets converted into mechanical work in case of the turbine, and we get the work output. Now that work output is divided into two parts. One goes into driving the compressor, which is the major portion of the work which is developed by the turbine, goes on to drive the compressor, and the remaining amount is available at the outlet, which is used as the net work. It can be used for the generation of electricity. So here we have a generator over which we are going to get the net work, which is W suffix net. And then when the work has been produced, we get the exhaust at point number 5, the exhaust gases. Now these exhaust gases, if it is not the regeneration method, would go directly into the atmosphere, and we are not utilizing this energy of the exhaust gas. So the better way is to bring this exhaust gas back at state 5 and let it pass through this heat exchanger, wherein in one of the pipeline we are having the compressed air which goes into the heat exchanger, and from the other pipeline we have the exhaust gases which are running. So what happens? The heat of the exhaust gases goes into the compressed air. It means the compressed air is heated by the exhaust gases, and at point number 6, now we are rejecting the exhaust gases back to the atmosphere. So what happens because of this heat exchanger and because of this regeneration method is that before the air enters the combustion chamber, the air is previously heated with the help of the exhaust gases. So by using this arrangement, we are reducing the total amount of heat which is supplied by the fuel, because already the air has been heated. So when we are supplying the fuel, its quantity goes on reducing, and when we reduce the amount of heat supplied, the thermal efficiency increases. So that is why regeneration method is one of the method used to increase the thermal efficiency of gas turbine power plant, and this can be explained with the help of the formula, that is, thermal efficiency is given by the general formula, which is W net upon heat supplied. And now when we can see here that the thermal efficiency is inversely proportional to the heat supplied. So the meaning of it is, if we want to increase the thermal efficiency, the heat supplied has to be reduced. So heat supplied can be reduced by using the regeneration arrangement, wherein we are reducing the amount of heat which is supplied by the fuel, and that is why QS, Q suffix S, the heat supplied reduces, so thermal efficiency will go on increasing. So this is one of the method which is employed in order to get the high amount of thermal efficiency for a gas turbine power plant by utilizing the energy of exhaust gases. Remember the important point that the exhaust gases are coming back and heating the air which is going into the combustion chamber. So that is why this is called as a regeneration method, where we are utilizing the heat of the exhaust gases to heat the incoming air which goes into the combustion chamber, and in this way the fuel supply will go on reducing, thermal efficiency increases. So in short, that was a description regarding the gas turbine with regeneration. At the end, if you'll find my videos helpful, you can like, share, comment and subscribe our channel and share it amongst your family and friends. Thanks for watching.